What's up everyone, my name is Dwight and welcome back to GeForce Garage. In our first skill guide of our Scratch build series, we learn how to use SketchUp, which allows you to experiment with the layouts of your components, or in our case, design a completely custom chassis for our rig. Using that design as a blueprint, today we're going to walk you through some of the basic metal fabrication techniques for PC modders. Once you get the hang of them, you'll be able to crank out custom parts and even entire enclosures, like this one that we made from scratch. Our guest today is David Cathey, also known as Insolent Gnome. David's built some of the wildest mods that we've ever seen, including the F3 Scout and the Gigantia, which is honestly pretty terrifying when you see it up close. Hey, David.
Hey, Dwight. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Pretty good.
Yeah, thanks for coming by. So I've done a little bit of metal fabrication, not a whole lot, you know, a little bit, but for those who are watching, what is metal fabrication?
Metal fabrication is whenever you cut, bend, or assemble metal.
So I assume that these are probably the basic tools that you need to kind of get your foot in the door?
This is a good place to start. Clamps to hold everything down, measuring devices so you can make sure all your measurements are correct, drills, jigsaws, and files.
Cool, let's get started. All right, Dave, well, I see we got a big piece of metal here. What's the first step?
The first thing we need to do is go back to our SketchUp drawing and figure out our measurements. And I've done that and made us a little cheat sheet.
Okay.
So we can now take these measurements, lay them out on our aluminum, and cut out everything we need to, and then get ready to bend.
Okay.
And I'm gonna use a square to make sure all my cuts are really straight because it's very important.
Yeah.
Perfect, and now we're ready to go ahead and cut this section out. So we're going to clamp it to the table, put on some safety glasses, and grab the jigsaw. Are we ready? So now we've got that cut, we can go back with a file and clean up any spots where we might have missed our line. All right, so we want to unclamp and we'll start laying out our measurements.
Okay. So how are we going to actually bend this?
I brought a brake. That's what I brought out earlier. Okay. And it's basically a big hunk of metal that we're going to clamp this down to, and it's going to allow us to bend with a little bit of force.
Okay.
So we're going to lay out our measurements, and that way when we're bending, we can bend all of it at once.
Okay.
Now you'll notice that I'm writing on this aluminum. And it seems crazy, but we're not actually writing on the aluminum. It does have a plastic covering. If it doesn't have that plastic covering, you can always use some tape where you're going to make your lines. And now we're going to use our square from our factory edge so we get good square lines. So next we're going to lay out our CPU cutout, and that's basically so we can get to our backplate if we have one on the board.
So you're marking out the CPU hole. I know we have a radiator one in one of these panels. Are we marking out that one too?
Not yet. We don't want to mark out some of the holes because they're so close to the bends that they actually make bending harder. There's a kind of a minimum distance that you want on
between
your piece
bends.
Bending. Yes.
Okay.
Because what it'll do is it'll either pull out of the break or it can screw up kind of how the bend goes. So now that we've got this marked out, we can use our drill, drill a pilot hole, and then use our jigsaw to cut this out, and then we're ready to bend.
Okay.
Go ahead and clamp your side down. I'll clamp my side. And always remember, safety glasses.
Right.
With that pilot hole, we can fit our jigsaw blade. And now we can go back and use our file to clean up any edges where we might have gotten off our line. So now that we've got our CPU cutout done, we need to mark one of our measurements. We're gonna have one bend that's actually backwards of all the rest of them because it's an inside bend. So we wanna mark that on the other side of our aluminum because we're gonna have to flip the piece over. We wanna make sure we go from the factory edge.
Which is on that side.
Now that we've got all that figured out, we're gonna wanna mount our brake up to the table.
Okay. Okay, so I noticed you're bringing in another bar. So can you walk me through what is actually here?
Yeah, brake is mainly a stationary bed, which is the part that we clamp down, bending leaf, which is the part that bends, and then a clamping bar, which is gonna hold our material.
While okay.
This is all very, very heavy metal because there's a lot of force on it. So now we're gonna stick our metal in there for our first bend.
So does this go on top?
So, yep. The clamping bar goes on top, and we're going to line it up with our line that we drew earlier, and then we're going to line that up with the line that between our leaf and our bed.
Okay.
So we're going to clamp this bar down close to our edges so our metal can't move, and we want to make sure that while we're doing this, we're not getting off our line. All right, now that we've got it clamped down, we need to know what angle we're going to bend. So I've gone ahead and measured our model that we did on SketchUp. And our first angle is going to be 78 degrees, which we're going to measure with a protractor. Grab that handle, and what we're going to do is bend this just a little bit close to what we want. We have 78 degrees, okay. But we want to make sure we don't bend right there or past, because you can always bend it further, but it's hard to take a bend back out of it.
Okay.
So go ahead and help me pull up on that a bit.
Okay.
That's good. And we're going to go ahead and measure that real quick. Got a ways to go. Keep on going. And then re-measure.
Okay.
A little bit mo. Let's go ahead and see what our angle is. But that's fine.
Yeah.
Now that we've got that bent, we can take it out and move to our next bend. And we set it up the same way with our clamp bar and our line, and line that up with the line between our bed and our leaf. And it does get better the further away you get from the ends because the brake starts holding the metal for you. And now I've went ahead and measured this one. This one is 110 degrees. I do want to cover the fact that we're actually not measuring the 110 degree bend that we're making. Mm-hmm. We're measuring the backside. So if this was 110 degrees on this side, we want to take 180 minus 110. And that'll give us the backside of the bend, which is 70 degrees.
Okay.
And we'll go ahead and make this bend.
Okay.
And we'll measure this. And we've got just a little bit further to go. That's good.
Okay.
All right, with that one done, I'm gonna flip it back over. Keep right on going. All right, you ready for our next bend?
Yeah.
Yep. It looks like we still have just a hair more to go. Definitely a feel thing.
Mm-hmm. Not bad.
No, we're pretty close. It'll work. And one more bend, and we should have this piece done. This one's a 90 degree angle. I'll have to go a little bit farther. I think we're pretty good. I'm gonna measure it real quick. And that's good. Now that we've got that all bent up, our first piece is done. Now we can go back in and take our jigsaw and cut out whatever hole we need for a radiator up here. And we can use this to make our next piece.
Okay.
We're getting ready to mark all our holes for our side panels to attach everything. And we're going to use a center punch to make sure our drill bits go where they're supposed to go. Now that we've marked those, we're going to clamp it. Now we're going to use a small bit to pre-drill a pilot. And I used a 16th inch bit there to pre-drill those, and that keeps my regular bit from wandering around. Now we're going to measure out the rest of our panels, get those cut out, and then we're ready for assembly.
All right, cool.
Now that we've got all our pieces cut and all our holes drilled, we can use these little mod blocks to hold our sides together. We've also got some small M3 screws, button heads. Those would be what we use to screw the panels together. And you'll notice that there's a little bit of an extra lip right here, and that's because in our SketchUp drawing, we had a slot of acrylic for an accent. And then our side piece will fit over and cover everything up.
Okay, well, how did you cut these ones out?
Actually, what I did was these two main pieces and laid it on the side on a piece of acrylic and drew the outline, cut it, and then filed it and sanded it to shape.
All right, so I noticed that there's also a mod block in the middle here.
And that's for our power supply. I'm worried about the power supply pulling on that side panel, so that's gonna help support it.
So Dave, I noticed that there's like a sanded finish on this. Is there a reason why you did that?
Yeah, I wanted to prep it for the next step of the process. And basically what I did was take 320 sandpaper and sand the finish down so the paint will stick to it. And I used a polisher, but you can use anything from just regular sandpaper with your hand to one of those little mouse sanders.
Okay. All right, one last question. What are these?
Those are the feet that we picked out for the case. They're billet case feet, and I thought they'd look really good with the project.
Okay, let's put it together.
The one thing to remember with a project like this, where there's a lot of bends, a lot of cuts, and a lot of screws, is you always want to measure twice. Or any miss in a measurement can add up over time.
Good to know.
And here it is, the final product. We've gone through, cut all our pieces, bent everything, added in our acrylic strips for some accent, and sanded it up and got it ready for the next step of the process.
It looks great. I really like the accent strips. Thank you very much for your hard work. I look forward to seeing what this is gonna look like at the end of the next step.
Me too.
Stay tuned for our next skill guide for some serious PC modding sorcery. We're gonna show you how you can print complex designs directly onto your chassis using a technique called hydro dipping. Until then, thanks for watching GeForce Garage, the ultimate resource center for designing, building, and customizing your GTX PC.